you actually have an extra 24 hours this year. This means you have 24 hours that you can do whatever you like. Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Brandy Morgan and we talk about all things freelance, working remote, and creating the life that you want. Be sure to subscribe if you want to be part of this freelance family. All right, today's video. You actually have an extra 24 hours this year. This means you have 24 hours that you can do whatever you like. And so I created a list of 5 things that you can do that will propel you forward in either your career, whether that's freelancing, or maybe you're just wanting to get a job in general, or you're fresh out of college, or maybe you're ready to graduate. These 5 things you can do in the next 24 hours to make sure that you are getting ahead in life and creating the life that you want. So no more excuses, because I'm pretty sure the number one excuse that I hear from people when I tell them about these different tips is that I don't have time. Well, now that excuse is invalid, because you actually do have an extra 24 hours this year to get this stuff done. And remember, when you're telling yourself that you don't have time, remember that we all make time for the things that we value in our life. So maybe it's time to reprioritize your life to see what's valuable and where you actually want to be in the next couple of years. All right, enough of me preaching. Let's get into the 5 things. The first thing that you can do is build that portfolio. I'm always telling people, if you are trying to get into freelance, you need to have a portfolio. Before I was a freelancer, I had a portfolio, but I never really used it, and oftentimes people didn't ask for it. But when you're a freelancer, you need to be able to point prospects to your work that's in one place. Your portfolio is your place in your space to brag about what it is that you do, what you've built, what you've created. Maybe you've worked with really awesome companies or brands. You wanna showcase that on there. You wanna walk them through what it is that you've built or you created in your life as a blank. Insert the skill that you have that you're trying to get a job or trying to freelance in. Now, if you're like, okay, well, I don't have time to build one from scratch, or maybe you don't have any programming knowledge to build a website, there's Wix, there's Squarespace. I'm pretty sure GoDaddy has a drag and drop website builder built into it, so you can buy a domain, get your hosting, and build your website all in one spot. The other thing is you can use Webflow. Webflow is something I haven't used, but I've looked into it a ton and I've heard great things, so I would highly recommend checking that out as well. So with that 24 hours, start building. Start designing the website you want or the portfolio you want. You can even go on WordPress, you can buy a template. WordPress has a ton of free templates and ones that you can actually purchase. They even have ones that are specifically for your portfolio. So look it up and start building. Number 2, start a blog. Why? Because you want to start building authority online through whatever topic you are freelancing in or whatever your skill set is. This is how you are going to brand yourself into an expert around that topic or that skill set. Now, you're saying, well, Brandy, I don't have time to build a blog from scratch, or I don't know anything about building a website. I totally get that. But just like the previous thing, there's already tools out there for you to use. You can use LinkedIn. LinkedIn has blogging right built into it, which is genius. You can be on there writing content that speaks directly to your audience or your prospects or your potential employers right on the platform where they are already at. So utilize LinkedIn blogging. Next thing, Medium. Medium.com is a free place to blog, and they already have the audience. There's already millions of users on that platform. All you really need to do is go up there and hit create, type up your blog post about your topic, add some hashtags, and you're done. And now your audience has the ability to reach a ton of people that you don't even know that are interested in the topic that you're talking about. Those two places are the two places I always tell people to start with, especially if they don't have their own website or B, don't want to set up their own website, maybe at this moment. And number three, since we just talked about LinkedIn, as you're blogging on there, stay on there. Take the time that you have and make your LinkedIn more professional and more searchable. I am going to give you a quick 5 tips of what you can do to make your LinkedIn page stand out to prospects and even future employers. The first thing you want to do is add keywords to your title. So LinkedIn, you have your name, and then you're going to have a title, what it is that you do. If you are somebody who is in the space of software development, you could put software developer or freelance software developer. You can put anything you want there, but those are keywords and those are searchable when people are searching on LinkedIn. So it's important to utilize that. The second thing is add your work history. I often see this part kind of looked over. When you want to make sure that it's in chronological order and each of those are specific about what you did at that job. So if you were a software developer at X, Y, and Z, you want to state exactly what it was that you did at that particular job. You want to go into detail and you also want to use key words. Maybe you're new to freelancing or new to your career and you don't have any work experience. You can go into accomplishments, there's a section there on LinkedIn, and start adding projects or things that you've worked on. And you can even link out to your portfolio, or you can link out to your Dribbble, your Behance, maybe your GitHub, whatever it is that you're using to create content or to share your work or your portfolio, you can link out to right there and you can talk about each of those projects specifically, maybe what you did on them and what you learned while doing them. The next section that is super important is the skills section. LinkedIn does a really great job of showcasing skills that you have to help show your profile to people that might be interested in hiring you. So you want to be specific. So if you're a developer, talk about the languages and frameworks that you know. Or if you're a designer, talk about the tools that you know. If you're a video editor, what software do you use? Whatever it is that you utilize, whether that's a language or a tool, you want to specify it, even those soft skills that you have, like communication. You want to add those things, or strategy, leadership, those skills, so then people, your connections, can go ahead and endorse those skills for you, which is my next tip, endorsements. While you're creating that skill section and filling it out, send people a message on LinkedIn asking them to endorse those skills. Oftentimes, you want to ask people that you've already previously worked with, or maybe you currently work with, or maybe even past classmates of yours if you're just getting out of school. Whoever it is that you're reaching out to, make sure that you've had some sort of, you know, professional or working interaction with them so they can genuinely and authentically endorse that skill that you have. And fourth, still on LinkedIn, if you are somebody that is really trying to get into freelance, I say this in all my videos, but I'm going to say it again, is that relationships are key. People want to work with people that they know and that they can get along with. So when you're on LinkedIn, start building out those connections. Start looking up different companies that you might want to work at or work with and start connecting with the people there. Connect with them. You can send them a message about who you are and what you do. Once you're connected with them, start engaging with their content, liking, commenting, resharing it. Start building those relationships now. And hey, you guys have those extra 24 hours, so you might as well use them. And my last tip for the extra 24 hours that you have, what idea do you have? Because most people have some crazy far out idea. Maybe it's for an app or a product, maybe an actual physical product or an online store, or maybe you want to create a course. Whatever it is, spend those 24 hours and start brainstorming or start building it. Start doing research towards that idea. The reason why is because often people are like, oh, I have this idea, but I have no time to do it. I have no time to build it. Well, you literally don't have that excuse right now because we have an extra 24 hours this year So do something with it. And do something meaningful and impactful to your life. Maybe it's just as far as creating a to-do list or a pros and cons list of what you want to build. But whatever it is, just start doing it. You're going to feel so much better. And you're going to find if you start building something or start making those steps, you will start finding more and more time throughout your year to allocate to what it is that you're trying to build. All right, you guys, I hope you guys liked this video. Let me know in the comments what it is that you are going to be doing for the next 24 hours, and I will let you know as well. Please be sure to like this video if you did, boop, boop, and of course, subscribe to my channel below. I hope you guys have a great day, and I hope you do something meaningful and impactful with your 24 hours.